Welcome to this module which will describe the procedure known as Gibson assembly. Gibson assembly is one of the most versatile tools which can be applied to assemble two PCR fragments to develop a gene construct. Gibson assembly is a cutting-edge DNA ligation technique developed by Dan Gibson at JCVI in 2009. It uses three enzymes to ligate two or more DNA sequences when they have overlapping end sequences at their joining point. These overlapping regions can be easily added to the ends of any length of DNA by using PCR with primers which have added flaps. Thus, PCR followed by Gibson assembly allows you to join any two blunt-ended pieces of DNA. The enzymes used in Gibson assembly are T5 exonuclease, TAC ligase, which will not ligate fragments that have a single mismatch, and fusion polymerase, which is a proofreading polymerase. Fusion polymerase is a high-fidelity polymerase which permits long-range amplification in excess of 7 kilobases. It has high processivity. DNA polymerase activity from the 5' to 3' end, and proofreading activity from the 3' to the 5' end. T5 exonuclease degrades double-stranded DNA in a 5' to 3' direction at 50 degrees Celsius. It generates 5' and 3' overhangs. TAC DNA ligase catalyzes the formation of phosphodiester bond between juxtaposed 5' phosphate and 3' hydroxyl termini of two adjacent oligonucleotides which are hybridized to a complementary target DNA. TAC ligase is a thermostable DNA ligase, which is stable at 45 to 65 degrees centigrade. It will not function if there is a single SNP. This ensures that the gene construct does not contain scars which will interfere with transcription and translation. T5 exonuclease degrades double-stranded DNA in a 5' to 3' direction at 50 degrees Celsius. It generates 5' and 3' overhangs. This is an overview of Gibson assembly. During the first step, T5 exonuclease is chewed back alongside the two DNA strands. Fusion polymerase and TAC ligase then facilitate the ligation and annealing of these two DNA fragments. Finally, fusion polymerase works in conjunction with TAC ligase to ensure that these fragments are sealed without the presence of a scar. Let us look at the various steps involved in Gibson assembly. In the first step, two PCR products can be joined together provided that they have flaps at the 3' terminal end of a product A and a 5' terminal end of product B. These need to be incorporated into the PCR fragments during the process of primer design. The step 1 of Gibson assembly involves the enzyme T5 exonuclease, which first chews back upon the terminal ends of the two PCR products to generate ends with overhangs. The second step involves the enzyme TAC ligase, which joins the overlapping regions at 50 degrees Celsius. The enzyme fusion polymerase now repairs the gaps to generate complete fused double-stranded DNA. The fused gene construct is now ready for downstream processing. This essentially completes the process of assembly, and the next steps can include DNA sequencing to validate the integrity of the DNA sequence, followed by cloning and expression in Escherichia coli or a suitable host. This completes your overview of the Gibson assembly protocol. Thank you for watching.